students, welcome to Vidya Mirad. Today I have come up with a very easy and interesting topic with a coordinate geometry for class 9, which is lesson number 3. Now these are the types of questions which generally come in your exam, and to do these you need to understand the video thoroughly. Please watch the video till the end before attempting these questions. Now let us first understand some important points relating to this video. Now if you see, there are two lines, x, x dash, y, y dash. Now these lines, they are intersecting at point O, which is called it origin. Now there is an horizontal line, okay, that is known as, and there is a vertical line or a standing line which is called as y-axis. Now you have certain numbers which you see which has no sign. No sign means there are positive numbers, and there are certain numbers which are with the negative sign or the minus sign. If you look into this green lines, they are the positive directions, and if you look at the red lines, they are the negative directions. Another important thing is your x coordinate is also known as abscissa, and y coordinate is also known as ordinates. Now, there are four quadrants you have seen. These four quadrants represents different x and y, which means you divide it into four parts. Your quadrant 1 is a positive x and positive y. Your quadrant 2, if you see the x, these are negative. If you see the y, they are positive. In quadrant 3, your x is also negative and y is also negative. And in quadrant 4, your x is positive and your y is negative. You need to take care of these and write your coordinates. Now, if you look into the graph, it's made so colorful, okay? These colors are just to help you to understand what I want to say. Now, there is a way of writing the coordinates. First of all, you remember this, your abscissa ordinate or x or y, it will be written in a form of x, y. X means the point on x axis, or y means the point of y axis. For example, if I talk about A, your A lies in quadrant 1. Quadrant 1 means your x and y both are positive. So what is the number I will represent? What is the coordinate? 4, 5. 4 is representing x and 5 is representing y. Okay. Now let's talk about B. B lies in quadrant 2, which means your x is negative but your y is positive. So here I can write it as minus 8, 1. Your C lies in the 3 quadrant or a quadrant 3rd, where your x and y both are negative. So I will write it as minus 4, minus 3. And last one, your D, the fourth quadrant, where your x is positive but your y is negative. So this is the way how we write down the coordinates, which is generally asked in your exam. Either they will give you the coordinates to plot it, or they will give you the graph or this diagram and ask you the coordinates. Now see, here I have given the coordinates, and I have written points, means you can represent these by A, B, C, D, E. If you look into the plane, see, I have shaded it for your reference. Point A, okay, the blue box represents -3, 7. Point B, if you see, x is 0 but y is -4. So you will mark only at -4 point. See children, you don't have to color it. So what you will do is, you can point that where your horizontal line and vertical line will meet, that point will be your ABCDE. Okay. If you look into the C, the green part, the corner of the green part will be your C. Your D is your purple box. So corner of the D where it represents 4, 4. That is your D. And same way the last is E, the red rectangular box which represent 2, -3. Now, see another I have given. Now you have to write down the coordinates of ABCD. So look at the quadrants and think what will be X and what will be Y, and representing the numbers, write down your A represents 7, 6. Your B represent -8, 5. Your C represent -7, -3. And D represent your 3, -6. And which you will write it into a tabular form to represent the coordinates. Now, again I am giving you one this coordinates. And you will mention it by ABCDEF on a Cartesian plane. Now look how I have drawn now. I have not shaded it. Now the point where horizontal and vertical lines are meeting, I put an arrow over there. That point is referring as your ABCDEF. Okay. So if you look at A, it is clearly showing -2, 4. Okay. If you look at B, 3, -1. Look at C arrow. It represents -1, -2. D represent 2, 5. E represent 4, -4. And F represent -3, -2. I hope, children, you must have understood the concepts which I was trying to explain in the coordinate geometry. Your X and Y coordinates are to be written in a systematic way. You need to take care of all the four quadrants and you need to point out, darken that point or circle it to mention your points on ABCDE to make your task easier. Thank you so much for watching the video till the end. See you soon.